Well, this is Dave with the Salty Dog. I've been working on all kinds of little glass repair. Some of it was major repair, some of it was just grinding out little pockets of moisture in the gel coat. You can see here on the deck of the bow, there was quite a few little spots of moisture that I had to grind out and just fill with epoxy putty. I'm still planning on taking these little short rails out, but I got to pull the headliner out so that I can get to the bolts on the underside. I've been working on that, and then over on the side of the gunwale, I've been working on repairs where I had to glass in a new piece here because it looks like apparently a downrigger ball hit the outside of the boat and it just crushed it here, and the radial cracks went down into here and it damaged all of this glass. So I cut it out and then I built a mold and built a piece and then I glassed it in, and then I had to glass on the underside, so it's pretty much done. I had to fill in some holes there. I've been working on getting everything glass-wise finished. The other day I was down in the cabin and I found an area where there are 16 little holes where they had a commercial plate mounted, ID plate mounted to the side of the hull. You can see them there. There's 8 of them, and then there's 8 over here on the opposite side, which are a little bit harder to see, but I'll show you. I repaired them. I laid glass in. I ground them out, beveled them out on a 12-to-1 ratio, and glassed them in. So they're all glassed in. Everything's been repaired, and the bow is pretty much done. The underside of the bow, where I put the high density Kusa board and plastic, that's the repair there. It's all done. Now I just need to come in here and paint it. I still have a couple of places here where I'm going to put stiffeners across this part of the deck, but I'll do that once I finish the hard top with my forward facing windshield. I'll show you a few more things I've been doing. Up on the bow, I've been filling other little places here, but up on the bow, I had to glass in a new piece, and that's all pretty much done. Now what I have to do is I'm going to put some gel coat on there, and I'll put some high gloss additive to it, and then I'll be able to sand it. Right now, because that's a laminating resin, if I try to sand it smooth, it's just going to gum up my paper. And then over here on the bow, on the front, I had a place where it looked like they had something else mounted. There were 6 or 8 holes, and I filled those with chop strand mat and a little piece of 1708, and that's pretty much it. Now the biggest repair that I did was this gunwale repair, and what I've done is I put gel coat on there, and I'm ready to start sanding it, get it sanded out smooth, and then I will sand all of the non-skid, because I'm going to put a new coat of non-skid on there, and so at that the old non-skid has to come off. The other thing I've done is I've taken the windows out of the side of the boat, and I'm going to have a new set of windows built for this. I also took out the port and starboard navigation lights because they're going up on the hardtop. So I got rid of those. at the base of the window frame, there were tons of mud cracks. The gel coat was probably 3/16 of an inch thick, and it had cracks going all the way down. It was really horrible. So what I did was I took my small Dremel with an 80 grit paper, and I sanded a groove down at the bottom, and then I took an inline sander and I sanded all of this down to get rid of the mud crack. Now I'm going to build my window frame, and I'm going to build the window frame so that it lines up with this outside edge. And then I'm going to glass it all to it, and so the hardtop will come down and it'll be a nice, smooth, continuous line all the way around it. So it'll actually look like a factory appearance. I still got to fill some of the areas where I had to grind it out because of the deepness of the cracks. But that's a minor thing. I'll use high strength putty for that. And but again, even here, the window frame is going to line up with the edge. And then as I glass down this way, I'm going to build it up to that edge. And then it's going to have a nice smooth line. It's going to flow. So it'll look like a nice factory job. Other things I found. Which I'm going to have to repair. On the side of the gunnel, you can see there's a ton of cracks going down into the gel coat, and it looks like it even goes down into the glass. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grind it out to the bottom of the cracks, and I may just lay a new piece of fiberglass from this edge to this edge and just create a new piece for sitting on top of this gunnel, so it'll reinforce that. Somebody excuse me, did some fiberglass work on this boat, and on the underside of the gunnel, and the glass doesn't even stick. I take a screwdriver and I can wedge it up in there, and I can actually bust it loose and pull it loose. It has very little adhesion. The other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to fill these pockets. That was for the rope for your cleat to go through, and the cleat was actually down underneath. I'm going to fill this in, and I'm going to put pop-up cleats on the side. So that way I don't have any ropes coming up over the top of my new paint job, damaging the paint job. Everything will be on the side of the boat, and it'll make for a much better situation for my new paint. The other thing I think I'm going to do is I'm going to put a piece of 1708 and a layer of chopped strand mat all along this edge. It's got all kinds of little itty bitty cracks, probably just from banging into it with ice chests and who knows what. But I'm gonna put a layer of glass on that, which will not only make the top of this thicker this way, but it'll add strength to the inside of that. Not that it's weak, it's not weak. I've basically glassed in everything, but just to give it more strength and a little more thickness never hurt. So I'm probably going to do that here. The next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to create a fish box that's going to cut back into the gunnel and come out, and it's going to run right down about here, right along the edge of this deck hatch, and it's going to come back over. I want a big fish box for bleeding out albacore tuna and also for sticking salmon in. So that's going to be my projects after I get this hardtop built. But I'm getting closer. I've got 16 holes to fill. These little guys down here, 16 holes that somebody just drilled into the side of the boat to drain the deck. And that's not going to drain anything. It may drain water, but it's not going to drain fish blood or anything else that gets on it. So I'm going to fill those in and that'll take care of that. Then the outside of the hull, as far as from the rub rail to the water line, is then ready for filler primer. So it's getting closer. Once I get the filler primer on there, I'm going to pull this bow rail off, and I'm going to fill all the holes for the bow rail. Excuse me. And part of the problem with this bow rail is it starts too far up. That bow rail needs to start clear back here and come up at an angle, and then go forward. The problem is if you step onto the gunwale going up the side of the boat, you've got to go quite a ways. You got to go clear up into here before you can grab it with without falling over the side. So I'm going to extend this rail about another 3 feet and actually bring it up higher. I'm going to raise that rail 6 inches because I don't like having to bend over when I'm walking up the gunwale to grab the rail. I would rather it be at waist height. And I'm also going to get rid of all the fittings. I'm going to have an 1¼" 316 stainless built in the same shape, but only taller, and extend this back in. So that's kind of where it's at. This repair this repair here took me a day to do because I had to glass it, I had to build it and then glass it in. And then right here, this was all damaged glass. So I ground it all out and I laid in some chopped strand mat and some 1708 and then another layer of chopped strand mat, and I built it back up so that it's the same shape as the other side. So it's every time it seems like I get somewhere, I fix a problem, two more problems crop up, or I happen to find them. And my buddies are all telling me, just, you know, don't worry about all those issues, just fix it to the point where you can slap some paint on it and get it in the water. But the problem with that is I won't be happy with that. Every time I get on the boat, if there's something I didn't fix, it's going to bother me. So anyway, I'm having a lot of fun. It's, to me, this is relaxation. I get off work and I come into my shop, heat it up. And right now it's 27 degrees outside, but it's about 66 degrees in the shop. So I'm nice and comfy in here. But anyway, if you have any questions, you can leave them at the bottom. I appreciate you for watching. Thanks. Hope you saw something that was kind of cool.